Hello, dear Steamians, YouTubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that Bitcoin is trading a little bit higher than the psychological level of $10,000 per digital coin. So namely the level of $10,000 and 154. Ethereum is approaching the psychological level of $200 and it's trading namely at the level of $197. So some of the major cryptocurrencies, they have recorded a slight uptick for the last 24 hours. But today I want to analyze the price, because it's Tuesday, the price chart of Steam, or our beloved cryptocurrency. That's why I will come back to the price charts, to the price chart, and I just want to mention at the very beginning some important, interesting news relating to Steam blockchain and our beautiful ecosystem. So the first thing I want to mention is that 14 hours ago, Steemit.marketing uploaded a very interesting video and wrote a post about the recent hard fork, about the new features of Steam blockchain after the hard fork took place 2 or 3 weeks ago. And I watched this interview with the Steemit senior blockchain engineer Justin, and actually he is the Steemit's head of engineering, Justin, and Vanderberg, and he is the Steemit senior blockchain engineer. And they talk a lot about the new features of Steam blockchain. They commented on the hard fork and what went wrong during the hard fork, but they said that the blockchain during this hard fork behaved quite well, and even it protected the blockchain. So its behavior. So they said that it means that Steam is really very solid blockchain and reliable blockchain. And I just want to mention that I will include the link to this interview and you can have a look at it and watch it, because it's really very interesting. But I want to mention that they said that because of the hard fork, because of the new features, because of the new reward system, slowly some Steemians started to come back to Steam blockchain. So we're talking about people that stopped to use Steam blockchain. Now they have come back and they have started to use Steam as well. And they said that the curation and the activity has grown since the hard fork. But to be honest, if I check the statistics, and I will show you the statistics of Arkanch. So this is actually the statistics of Arkanch. This is the number of active user, this user. So this chart is, or chart is illustrating the number of active users. To be honest, it is still too early to say that the number of active users have increased since the hard fork. And also, I'm not pretty sure that active users, active curators, that the curation or has become more active as well. So I think it's too early. We need time. We need at least a couple of months to see if the hard work, if the hard fork was beneficial or to our ecosystem. So let's keep an eye on the activity of on Steam blockchain according to the statistic of Arkanch. Of course, on a regular basis, I will update you. That's why let's move now to the price chart of Steam. According to the beautiful site of CoinGecko, we see that Steam is trading at the level of 15 cents, 0.355. So this is one of the lowest. This is the lowest level since the first half of 2017. Even in December of 2018, the price was significantly higher. I say significantly higher because it was close to the psychological level of 20 cents, so it's almost 30% higher than it is now. It used to be 30% higher than it used to be now. And let's have a look at the price chart And now let's have a look at the price chart. So this is the price chart of Steam against the US dollar. We see that we have this sequence of descending highs and descending lows. So it is clear that we're in a downtrend. So it's a bear trend or bear market. So there is nothing new actually. But let's start with the broader picture and let's have a look at the monthly chart. So this is actually how the price chart of Steam looks on 1 month time frame. And we see that we still have this sequence of bearish candlesticks with descending highs and descending lows. So this is a bearish signal. And to be honest, it means that at the moment there is nothing so bullish on the price chart. If we switch to 1 week time frame, the situation is quite similar. We have this sequence of mainly bearish candlesticks with descending highs and descending lows. Of course, the candlesticks are becoming slowly smaller and smaller. I mean that their bodies are smaller and smaller if compared to the previous ones. And to some extent, it means that probably Steam is going to face some support in the near future. But just a short reminder that we still have this sequence of descending of candlesticks with descending highs and descending local lows. So it means that we have this bearish signal. If we switch to 1 day time frame, just a short reminder that we're in a kind of descending channel. So this is the descending channel. And actually, we're very close to the lower line, so or the lower bound. And the price chart is fluctuating very close to this lower line. And there is no doubt that at some time, probably we may see some kind of rebound. But it's hard to say when it will happen. Will it happen now? Will it happen a little bit later or even much later? But we may see some kind of price rebound. But I just want to let you know that according to the technical analysis and the candlesticks analysis I have been applying for quite some time, we have a bearish signal because this is a downtrend or descending channel on 1 day time frame as well. So that's why, to be honest, I don't see any bullish signal on the main time frames of Steam price chart. And it will be nice if the situation changes somehow in the near future, but let's see what will happen. We will keep an eye on the price chart. That's it for today about the price of Steam. Now let me mention some news. The first thing I want to mention is that Binance US to accept, so the cryptocurrency exchange Binance US to accept deposits Wednesday. So tomorrow, yes, tomorrow, today is Tuesday, Binance US will start providing services to the citizens of the United States. And of course, this is very beneficial for the cryptocurrency exchange Binance itself. And of course, to some extent, I think it's good news for the cryptocurrency world as well, because it means that the infrastructure of the cryptocurrency world is constantly developing. Also, the last thing I want to mention today is that, fellas, this is the Steemit account of DTube. This Friday, September 20th, DTC or DTube coin token sale round number one. Just a short reminder that on Friday, the first ever DTube coin initial exchange offering will take place. So, as we're DTubers, or most of us are DTubers, it would be nice if we somehow support the ecosystem of DTube. And I will include a link to this post under my video so you can see how we can enhance the DTube community. We can engage in some of their ecosystems on Discord, Twitter, etc., and spread the word about DTube. And of course, we can participate in this token sale. The price of one DTC will be fixed during the initial exchange offering at the level of $0.1 or 10 cents. And of course, we will be able to trade them in quarter four of 2019. That's it for today. Once again, the initial exchange offering of DTC token will take place on Friday. So fellas, if you want, you can support the DTube ecosystem. And of course, I will also try to support it. I will participate in this initial exchange offering. That's it for today. I wish you a wonderful day, of course, and hope to see you in my next video. It was me at CryptoSpark.